Okay.
Are you ready or no?
Well,
let's put some. So I will use Mars's. Yes, as always.
Mars's.
Yeah, for the shadows.
So Mars black?
Hmm?
Mars black?
No, I mean Mars's, the brown ones. Yellow, transparent Mars yellow, transparent brown Mars, and transparent orange Mars. We don't have that in your country, but you can use some.
What's that? I think it's band number.
So I will maybe black, black paint. You need only. Means only for gray. That's why you put black next to white paint.
Okay.
You always put that. I'm teaching you my school. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You always put white in the corner of the palette here.
Mm-hmm.
Great. You have to
can I borrow your white? Yeah, I have zinc white.
It doesn't matter.
I have to take it, it's like almost gone.
Because Anastasia has it only in a huge, huge can.
I don't want to have a huge can. All right. So for me, I have burnt umber and burnt sienna, and that's almost it for the browns. I have also what is it? This yellow ochre.
Yeah, use all of them.
All of these.
Yeah. It just needs a lot of browns too.
I need a red and a yellow.
Yeah, I just used red, yellow, ultramarine. I'm using lemon yellow always.
Okay.
And I'm using cadmium. Vermilion red, it says.
Okay, well, should I clean my palette?
Probably, yeah. That would be good. Can I borrow your.
Yes. This?
Yeah, that's all. No, I mean,
right.
No. I forgot the word.
Spirits.
Yeah.
Gamsol.
How do you call it?
Well, it's called. They call it Gamsol.
No. I mean,
but yeah, it's a mineral spirit.
Yeah, I still just call it somehow. Nice.
Spirits.
No.
Solvent.
Yeah. Very bad in analysis. It was because I never studied painting in English. So I'm gonna paint and you're just gonna repeat after me, I guess.
Yeah.
I can put some paint.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah. Just maybe clean some surface so it's not too dirty.
Maybe do it some solvent.
Let's see. I can use a paper towel.
Yeah. Do you record on an iPad too? Yeah, just the time lapse.
So the thing about portraits is in classical school you don't do head on the canvas more bigger than your real head.
Oh, okay.
So when artists doing huge heads on canvas, it's always not like
it's
classical
it's
stuff.
Strange.
Yeah, strange. But they do it anyway, but not in classic school.
Okay, so zinc white.
All the solvents are getting dry differently. For example, if you use oil, it will not get dry at all, like 7 days,
uh-huh.
weeks.
Right.
If you, as a solvent. If you use varnish, it will get dry very quick.
Mm-hmm.
But for the first under painting, you use just regular solvent,
mm-hmm.
usually. Because it dries pretty quick and it's cheapest and
mm-hmm.
easiest. Because you cannot paint only on varnish.
Mm-hmm.
For varnish you have to add oil, a little bit of oil or this gum soap.
Okay. Cadmium yellow? Or is it too warm?
Maybe. You can just look what colors you have.
Roll in this bag.
You cannot make a lot of colors out of this two orange and two.
This one?
Maybe yeah, it's better. Because your colors have to be basic mostly. Like pure ultramarine,
So am I laying this out right? I have my warm red sienna here.
You just have to be consistent. I mean,
okay.
Just do every time do the same order of colors.
Okay.
Yeah, I would put it here. Yeah. Because it has to be some kind of gradient.
Mm-hmm. And the red?
My teacher told me that all the earthy colors, you know, like
earthy colors?
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
should be on the top mm-hmm. and all the. But I like keep red and yellow on top too.
Cadmium, red, medium?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
that's okay.
My
first. Okay, and more ultramarine. Ultramarine light? Just French ultramarine.
Mm-hmm. And some green, emerald green. You have some.
No, I don't.
Very useful. You need just to tie in a bit of it. So, to make everything also. To make everything emerald.
Yeah.
Or just to add. To, it works with different colors very good. It works with white. Very cool.
Yeah, I don't have any green.
Okay, then anyway. Just forget about it.
Alright.
I'm not gonna use it, a lot of it anyway.
Do we put some linseed oil? Oh, no.
No, for a la prima,
just this.
Mm-hmm. You put linen oil and varnish into the solvent to make your painting more crispy and clear.
Linseed oil?
Yeah, because only on this it will get dull, mm-hmm. dark, mm-hmm. apparently. But if you put some varnish on top, it will get crispy.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm starting with just with drawing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, do the same.
Yeah, I'm gonna swap these around because it's driving crazy.
Is it too low for you?
Yeah.
I can go there.
No, it's okay. This will work. But I need to protect that. Uh-huh.
You can put
plastic
some. You can.
You have one?
Yeah, I have some. On the second drawer. On the left.
Use this?
Yeah, everything's
not,
fine.
Not as a pump, just the protection. Just to protect the chair.
Okay.
It's not going to get very messy, so I don't plan on getting it very messy. My favorite brush.
You got the best, the hottest painter in the world.
What?
It's before the Kiss concert starts. The hottest band in the world, Kiss. So I forgot about composition a little bit, so I'll fix it.
So, starting with just this one color.
Yeah. Just start as you would start with a charcoal of the paint. Yeah. Don't care about any. And you want to draw with shadow lines more. So instead of drawing eye and brow, you just draw where the shadows would be. Is it clear or not? No. Try to keep it super light. I mean, use a lot of solvent. Like watercolor. And if you are sure in some part of your drawing, you can add more color just to fix it. Like this.
I might find the same picture on my iPad just because it's a little bit distorted. What's the
Lana Turner?
Is it, what's her name?
Lana Turner.
Lana Turner.
I feel like you're
you're
suffering. Are you gonna keep it? Computer. On the laps. We can put it here instead of.
The better?
Maybe it seems.
This one seems a bit squished now.
Oh.
Is it really good?
Okay?
Yeah.
So I love to put some, do you remember I told you about pitchfork?
Yeah.
So I told you about colors, but also for the, or you can call it cornerstones or something like that. Something to keep your or anchors,
landmarks
or yeah, something to keep your inside the proportions and
yeah,
so I love eyes mostly for that purpose. I put two dark strokes as eyes and try to do to work around it. Make something fun. If you did something wrong, you can use some solvent to erase it. For example, I fucked up this nose. It's even simpler than with watercolors because you cannot erase watercolors.
Yeah.
I did this shadow, but I feel that this is too too heavy, too strong. So basically, yeah, you are doing drawing with only one color and one paint and one brush. Mm-hmm. Not one brush, just. Try to keep it as transparent as possible. Mm-hmm. But the trickiest part is the less solvent you use, the fastest it will dry.
Get dry.
Mm-hmm. Too much solvent and just
okay,
and down,
but it's not over.
No, it's just did something wrong. I'm melting. You have to be super self-confident for painting. That's one of the secrets. Just be very confident no matter what you're doing. What you are doing. Yeah, yeah, I'm doing more contrast. And
I'm doing
yeah. I mean, no, not there. Just
get through your eyes because it's too strong.
Just, yeah, the strongest part of your painting now, it's E.
Mm-hmm.
You see it?
Okay.
All the accents are here. So do it on the photo. Do all the accents on face, and eyes, nose. Still going down and down.
Going down and down and down.
Yeah, that's better now. Mm-hmm. Don't be afraid, please. You can go darker. Well, wait. Just repeat up after me, I guess. Do some strongest and darkest parts. Like drumming, because life is chocolate. Do this line more.
Stronger?
More. Not stronger, just
more defined.
More, yeah. So you'll not be confused when you're doing those things. I don't know what. Maybe let's do the background.
Okay.
I'll mix without any white. I'll mix some blue. What it will be? I think it's something like gray, like linen or something like that.
Okay. Did I use the same brush or a different brush?
I took different one.
Different one.
Oh, I forgot about okra. Right.
Oh, different.
I know. Yeah. No, you can use
close. This one.
Oh, actually, yeah,
it's fine.
Mm-hmm. So instead of white, I'm adding some okra. How do you call it? How do you pronounce it?
Okra.
Okra. Yeah.
Okra.
Maybe okra and a little bit blue.
So I mix okra and blue.
Kind of. I don't know.
See what happens.
Yeah. Let's see. I just want some dark and not saturated color. But I don't want to do this black and white.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of this, I'm doing something a little bit more interesting. Anastasia would do something a little more interesting because she likes to mix all the weird colors.
Yeah.
I'm doing it pretty simple. Like, there are several levels of, like, music and every art.
Yeah.
Basic, like, people would do just, okay, it's black and white picture, I would just mix black and white and I'll go with that, and maybe I'll make red lips and blue eyes, you know. But second level is to mix two colors instead of black and white, to, like I do ochre and blue, for example.
See, maybe should I add some? Maybe some of this one.
So. You can. You just try.
Okay.
I wouldn't recommend to mix more than three colors.
Okay.
I mixed It was black already. So I don't want to add anything else. But now I'm not using black, actually. I'm just doing it with two. We are doing background just to make, just to not to be distracted with white color of the canvas.
Okay.
When we are making, when we will be painting, when we will paint face. Just not to be distracted. If it would be, would have been just a gray linen,
uh-huh.
I would just use it.
Just leave it.
Yeah, just leave it. But we have cheap Chinese white canvas, so we have to cover it with something. And we cannot leave it orange as we left it, because orange is too bright and too intense color. You will not understand the correct color of a face with orange background.
Mm-hmm.
You get the idea.
Yeah. It's kind of like we're saving that intensity for the face.
Yeah. So I'm not thinking a lot about background color, and I'm just one color. It's not to be distracted. And I just will leave it like this, because here we don't have face. Now we have the biggest contrast here.
Oh, should I like?
Yeah, blend it in. Like this. You can even do like this. Like with charcoal.
Yeah.
You're doing it with charcoal. Why are you confused with paint? I mean, I would understand if you would do terrible charcoal, but you're doing great. Just relax and do everything that you already know how to do.
Okay, that feels a bit more set back, right?
Yeah. Now, you see, it's looking pretty good. So, what now? I would add more color to the hair shadow, I guess. I would leave almost like this here in the shadow of her face.
Okay.
But for the hair, I would do something more cooler. I would use more same as background.
Mm.
But just because blondes has always cool shadows, you know. So,
mm-hmm.
Somewhere.
Okay.
So and also blend it with the background more. So, again, finish. I wouldn't just leave it like this here. I would blend it more, because we'll add strokes on top to cover it.
Okay.
After. you know, light strokes, it will be cooler.
Yeah.
It will be better if
yeah.
you if it'll just cover this shadows.
Uh-huh.
Instead of leaving, like, you know, in the coloring book. Yeah, not doing coloring book. We want to layer paint on
okay.
top of each other.
Yeah.
Because it's, you know, it's better. So now I would mix some color for the for her skin. We are starting with white, and I'm pretty basic here always.
Yeah.
That's not my strongest part.
So you're starting with white.
I'm just, I love very simple color, skin color,
mm-hmm.
like red and yellow and white, but some artists would do it more, so it's like first level of, you know, when I told you about black and white.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
So white, red and yellow, it's kind of first level.
I'm surprised you don't use this one.
You can, yeah, but yeah, it's just you can use because I can explain with with Mars red or orange or yellow or brown, it will be a little bit unexpected what you will get, and it will add. Some I don't know. Anastasia loves mixing Mars with white,
mm-hmm.
but I love to be very. I know what I will get
mm-hmm.
at
yeah.
the end. That's why I'm always doing it simple for that. Then I will add layers of different skin tones and like redness and blue,
okay.
but for basics I. And I'll cover that white canvas here. So I'm always painting it against the form. And I blend it into the shadows. There are always some places you see some crispy
mm-hmm.
shadow, in, you know,
mm-hmm.
sharp
mm-hmm.
here and a little bit here and here
mm-hmm.
and eyes and very sharp here.
Mm-hmm.
But everything on the shadow there are always two edges of it. Different, you know, edges.
Mm-hmm.
One is always sharp,
yeah.
and another one is always blended.
Uh-huh.
And also on this stage, I'm fixing my drawing.
Yeah.
Because with white, I can fix what I cannot. Sorry, I'm getting tired and keep forgetting words. So on this stage you can fuck up all your job. Because it's, you know, it's hard to
stuck to it.
Stuck to, yeah. It's easier when you, if you have like drawing or charcoal drawing from at the bottom
of your painting.
Underneath your painting.
Okay, and then do you bring the tone down?
What do you mean?
Or like, is it all one color?
No, I just no, I mix, add some yellow here, some mm-hmm. red here.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I don't care really about it. I'm just, it will be different at the end. Anyway. But your tone is very light because I don't want, I mean, I would do highlights with that color.
Uh-huh. Okay.
But we are not doing highlights now, we are doing the basic color.
Okay.
That's why I did shadows pretty intense.
Mm-hmm.
So that will give me some room to use other colors. And your shadows were super light. That's why you're using the right color comparing to your shadows.
Uh-huh.
But I would do all a little bit darker.
Okay.
Not a little bit, maybe two tones darker. So it, so we'll have more room to add more highlights and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And contrast when we'll need it. And now also I'll do hair. I would just mix ochre and yellow and white. That's the basic level again.
Ochre, yellow and white.
Yeah. I'm not supposed to be oil painting teacher. Definitely, that's not my strongest. I can teach you how to draw comics.
Yeah.
Oh, I wrote a comic.
Are you still doing like your tutorial tips and stuff?
Oh no, no. I just did it like 1 week on. It's hard.
Yeah.
You know how it is. And we want to blend where, you see, we, here we don't have any So I would love to blend it with the color of the skin, just so it looks more artsy, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, too yellow.
Too much yellow.
Yeah.
She's a little white.
She's just platinum blonde, yeah. So you kind of always dancing between light and shadow, between light and dark, between
cooler and warmer tones.
Uh-huh. No, you're doing good. So why, why did you finish shadow here?
I was thinking about doing the flower.
Oh.
But maybe it's a bad idea.
Yeah, forget about flower.
Okay.
We need just face.
Okay. Okay. So should I fill it?
Just yeah, blend this. So now I look at my painting and I see that shadow is too bright, and now we need to tone down shadow.
Okay.
So I would put another layer of some paint, but now I would choose something more complicated instead of just one painting, instead of one brown. I would just use maybe some ochre and maybe even blue a little bit.
So some yellow ochre and some blue.
No, without yellow, just ochre and blue.
Ochre, blue.
Because that will help us make this shadow darker and a little bit less warm, because apparently here it will be more cooler shadow.
Okay.
Cooler reflects.
So you're adding,
I'm adding a little bit cool tones inside this dark, to make it darker, because now it's too bright, you see.
Uh-huh.
It's now it's almost as bright as,
yeah.
So I'm bringing this a little bit down, is adding cooler tone, cooler colors, and no, I'm not gonna paint inside the shadow almost. So it's,
sort of similar to the background
to me, yeah. I just want add more cooler color instead.
This one's getting kind of green.
Kind of too dark. And so. The color is fine, but too dark. And I will do another layer on the background because now the background looks too bright for me. I wanna her face to shine in the dark.
Yeah.
That's why I want to add more. But your background is kind of beautiful. Very well. Tone of your painting. Basically, I'm like you, I'm more graphic artist instead of color. But I just, because all my tricks about colors, they're super simple, they are like basic level. So I'm not the best guy to teach you how to color stuff, but anyway, because I know how I should do it to look good.
Too dark, yeah.
Probably, yeah. Just look at your painting and see where you have like problem areas and try to fix them. That's simple. I see here is too sharp. And now, when we did this part, I wanna add more cool tones to her face. Again, for cool tones, I'm looks like I'm using always blue and ochre, because if it's just blue, it would be just light blue, right? And white, but ochre will calm it down a little bit, make it more complicated. I'm mixing blue and ochre with the skin tone.
With the skin tone now.
Yeah. And I'm adding these strokes to the mid-tones, yeah, some parts. And same, we can same color we can use here on the reflex.
Mm-hmm.
But be careful with that because it should be very, very subtle. Yeah. And on ear, it should be on like. Almost the same tone as shadow, but a little bit less. And I will use some hair. Instead of flower, I'll do just reflex. I can think of something.
So, I have quite a fair bit of white showing through.
What do you mean?
You think it matters?
Hi?
I have quite a bit of white still showing through.
Still showing through? Oh,
yeah.
In the camp? You don't want any white inside of your main area.
Uh-huh.
You can leave some white here because it
yeah.
doesn't matter. You just look into
yeah.
this. But you don't want any distractions. You see, I'm almost don't have white except
yeah.
maybe here, but certainly. But I covered all white on my first steps. Looks like you added more pink instead of blue.
Instead of the blue.
Why?
Well, that was when I was still doing the skin.
Mm-hmm.
So, should it look
like? I would, yeah, because what I was gonna say now, she looks like a corpse a little bit now because
uh-huh.
she doesn't have any skin redness and stuff.
Yeah.
So, I would add skin redness on this.
Level
on this step
okay.
When I have all blues and
uh-huh.
before highlights.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
Alright, so should I
Yeah, I would do instead of red I would use some cold paint.
Some blue?
Yeah, because it's you know, it's on the edge between light and shadow. The coldest part, actually.
Uh huh. Okay, so. This.
Yeah. Same thing there. Yeah. And you see, we still have. Canvas in the shadow.
Yeah. It's good.
Yeah, that's the point of our lesson. Are you gonna stay today?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay.
Won't you come?
What?
It's blue.
Better?
Yeah. Or maybe the maybe it's good that the blue went on top of the pink.
No, it's just better with blue.
It's just better with blue. And so here as well?
Yeah, yeah.
The blue.
Because actually you didn't do this you see, I added blue but I left warm shadow.
Yeah.
So but you added blue and you there's already
no
yeah, there's no warm.
Can I add some?
Yeah. But
it's not
gonna
work now.
No, it still can work because you still have very thin layer of paint. Yeah. You see, it's even better now.
Okay, yeah.
Contrast, I love contrast. Go, contrast. So we are doing kind of, how can I explain that? Like a very rough, you know, when you do a sculpture, you're doing it very rough first.
Yeah.
First steps.
Yeah.
Just to get the main form and idea of everything. But then when we will have all these basic colors, we will do details.
Okay.
Then. So we are doing them now instead of details because we want it to be like same idea of the whole painting. I don't know, it's super hard to explain, but
you're doing great. No, I mean it's not as what you're doing is best.
My favorite part of painting is always eyes, so I'm gonna...
It's always what? Eyes?
Eyes.
Okay.
I hate when the eyes are not painted.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm gonna... I'm gonna add some contrast because it's gonna be the biggest contrast of my painting. So I'll add some almost black, but I'm not using black, I'm using Mars brown. So it's a little bit early, but we'll go deep into details for a little bit. Because I just hate when the portrait has no eyes. It's kind of my thing, my fetish. Also, I'll add some of this cold near the eyes, because usually we have a lot of cold around our eyes. So it's too dark, but I'll make it lighter. Mine looks like a gem key. It does, it's red. I'm gonna fix it. You never want to do white, very white inside of eyes.
Okay.
It's always, I did it darker, so I will have shadow when I will add more white on top. I will still have some shadow inside of it.
Okay.
This eye looks so much bigger than the other one.
I don't like it.
Again, just instead of redness on skin, I'm just decided to fix my drawing.
Okay.
On the stage a little bit. So I'm adding more contrast on the edges of
the shadows.
Shadows, yeah. Because I love contrast. Yeah, contrast is the main, always the main thing in my everything, my art. So I will add some red color. Oops, dark red. Because we see a very big highlight. So I'll add really dark.
What's going on?
He fell.
What did he do?
What came out?
The bread doesn't come out.
Yeah, wait a second.
Наделали что-то немножко оба.
Настоящий сайт из студии.
Майн?
Майн.
Йорс?
Студиати.
Студиати? What did we do?
But now it's... I don't understand why you pick black and white picture.
Because... That's why.
Because fuck you, that's why. We do, maybe we do another one.
No, because we don't need any colors to distract us.
But that's painting, you know? That's how it works.
Yeah.
I thought that it would be easier for me. Anyway. Oh, for me too. Because we sometimes on the color photo, it's very confusing always.
Hard to see the values and stuff.
Yeah, hard to see the values, yeah. Values may be
opposite or something like not very clear. But on the black and white painting picture, you making it out of your head how it's supposed to be. Because I know how it's supposed to be. And that's what I'm trying to explain to you. And that's why I chose black and white. Do eyes too, because your eyes is... I'm looking at your painting and I see that eyes is not done and not there, and mouth and nose is, are good, but eyes, no. If you remember what I told you, your painting always should look like it's finished on every step. And I will add more redness to the skin tone.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just trying to get it. Darker, because if I make them darker,
okay. You can make some strokes on it, like, yeah, the eyes darkest part of
yeah.
The painting. On the edges, always do on the edges of like charcoal. How are you doing it in charcoal?
Uh-huh.
Think about it. Just do it same but with the brush. I'm fixing weird parts of my painting.
Okay. What's the same?
He's
like, he's like the one who falls out of a tree.
Yeah, yeah.
The one who's like, that's crazy. Whoops.
Парень, в чем дело? Ну что это такое? Иди,
oh,
иди, ляг.
Soaking.
Иди сюда. Грейс, ну ты можешь на маленькой лежать. Ну, ты можешь тут полежать, потом вполне себе. А ты вот тут полежи. Ложись. Что, не выдумывай.
So to be honest, my painting looks more like a drawing with a little bit of color.
Uh-huh.
But that's fine for me. What? What's that? You want to say something? Want to criticize me?
No. No, I can give you a kiss. В качестве утешения.
Отойди, у нас там камера снимает.
Ничего страшного.
I actually love how it turns out.
You like it?
You made a light part very thin layer of paint.
Yeah.
Yeah, look how I did a lot of
thick. Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe not super but thicker, especially in some parts. That's why you see you always get this contrast in everything. Not
yeah.
Only in color and tone, but in thickness of a paint also.
Yeah.
So that contrast is the main point of, I would say, of the cool looking painting.
Yeah.
Oh.
What?
It's really bad outside.
Yeah.
It's like pouring.
cool. Some cool highlights. I think I'll finish for today. Maybe we can continue tomorrow.
Sure.
But still a little bit like a la prima, right?
Yeah.
I'm pretty happy with that.
Yeah.
Where's the wine? For the highlights, I always mixing white and lemon yellow. I don't know why, I just love the color. Same in digital. I'll give you the of this. Maybe watch. Because I'm doing every painting, every portrait painting, basically the same way. You can do your father's portraits or something like that at home, and you'll show me some kind of homework. No, I'm not kidding.
Yeah.
You can do that and we'll see. If you want to study, then let's do it.
Yeah.
Actually, I love it. I mean, it's easier for you to work after.
You love what?
The tone now.
The tone now is getting better.
Yeah, I think so. Because it gives you, as I said before, it gives you room to do highlights and all this stuff. Pure gold hairline. My painting looks like a painting from 50s, like pin-up painting, classical pin-up painting. Right?
Yeah.
It's so funny. I never wanted. Made it not on purpose. Maybe I should paint up more.
Yeah.
Just need cool photo reference because they all use photos.
Yeah.
The references.
So,
what?
Before the highlights, should I put more?
Yeah, add more cool tones on the between light and shadow. Like you return back to the step. I don't remember.
Okay, so cool tones in here.
Yeah. Here and here on all where we can see light gray, basically.
Okay, and it should be a mid tone.
Yeah. Done it.
Ну, по рисунок просто. Я просто, знаешь, что сказать, вот зачем такую пенаповскую фотку выбрали бежевую? Надо было естественное лицо с ненакрашенными губами.
Мне нравится.
Не, ну понимаешь, что тебе нравится, но для обучения это очень тяжело.
Ну, я подумал, что... Ну, мне легко объяснить было. Ну, в смысле, легче, чем на каком-нибудь. Окей, so, should I stop my video?
Yeah, I guess. You feel finished, right?
Yeah, I'm just super tired.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.